people don't just pass from my videos, instead they pass with flying colors, which is well evident in the comment section of my previous videos. To answer this type of question, you first need to understand the concept of transient failure and permanent failure. A transient failure occurs due to a circumstance which is temporary and will soon return to normal, at which point the rule execution will succeed. Whereas permanent failure occurs due to a change in the condition that allows the rules to run, which without human intervention will not return to their former status. Now let's tackle this question. Let's first look at option A, that is deleted target workspace. Deleted target workspace would never return to normal unless human intervention. In layman terms, just think like you have uninstalled a software from your system. Do you think the same software will get installed automatically? No, right? Therefore, it doesn't belong to the category of interim or transient failure. Rather, it's a permanent failure. As per the question, we need answers related to transient failure. Therefore, incorrect choice will reject this. Let's now look at option B, that is rule query takes too much time to run and then time out. If a rule or a query is taking too long to execute, then this can be a temporary issue, especially when the server workload is too much. When the server load will be less, then the query will run fast. Since this belongs to transient failure category, we'll keep this option aside for the timing because we need two correct answer as per the question. Let's now look at option C, data source permissions of the rule query were modified. Once a permission is removed, the permission won't be restored automatically. Permission needs to be granted explicitly by some kind of human intervention. Therefore, seems incorrect, we'll reject this. And the last option left by the process of elimination is connectivity issues between log analytics and the data sources. Looks good. If you look at the official documentation, I have marked the incorrect ones with the red pen and the correct answers with the yellow highlighter. You can have a look at the transient failure and permanent failure with respect to the exam because it might come in handy, and we'll lock B and D as the correct answer for this. Alright, this question will test your concepts on JIT. Let's first look at option A, that is at workspace level. Enabling Azure Defender in workspace level doesn't enable JIT or just in time. Therefore, it's an incorrect choice or invalid option rather. Let's now look at option B, at virtual machine level. Just enabling Azure Defender won't enable JIT for all Azure resources as required by the question here. Therefore, it's again an incorrect choice. Let's now tackle option C and D together, that is at resource level and subscription level. Both subscription level and resource level will work, but we got to choose the best option because as per the question, we need one correct answer. Since we can protect the entire Azure subscription with Azure Defender by assigning at the subscription level, as all the Azure resources will automatically inherit from it, hence option D, that is at subscription level, looks to be a better fit than option C. Hence, we can reject option C. And if you look at the official documentation, it's clearly written, you can protect an entire Azure subscription with Defender for Cloud's enhanced security features, and the protections will be inherited by all resources within the subscription. That's what is required. Hence, we'll lock D as the correct answer. Alright, this question is related to roles. Seems interesting question. Let's first look at option A, that is Azure Sentinel Reader. Sentinel Reader role can only view incident. As per the question, we need to assign and resolve incidents as well as marked here in the keyword. Doesn't quite fit well as per the requirement. Therefore, we'll reject this. Let's now look at option B, that is Azure Sentinel Automation Contributor. As the name of the role suggests, it's related to automation. Automation contributor role can add playbooks to automation rules, which we certainly don't require as per the question. Seems incorrect choice. Don't just pass your ID certification, pass with flying colors with my keyword tricks exclusively meant for diamond members. Become a member now by clicking the join button. Let's now look at option C and D together, that is one is responder role and other is contributor. Both will meet the goal, but we need to follow the principle of least privilege as per the question. Apart from assigning and resolving incidents, as a Sentinel contributor role, if you look, can even create or edit workbooks, which certainly is more than what is needed as per the question. Therefore, option C, that is responder, is definitely a better option than option D. Therefore, we'll reject option C, D, and keep option C and lock responder as a correct answer for this. Alright, this question is about fusion rule. Seems interesting question. Let's first tackle option C and D, that is Azure Log Analytics and add storage account. Log Analytics and storage account are totally out of context as it has nothing to do with fusion rule, therefore an incorrect choice. Let's now look at option B, that is re-enable the rule after disabling. As per the question, the rule is already enabled. Just like if a bulb is of 10 watts and you want it to switch off and then switch it on again, it won't change the 10 watt power of the bulb, right? Similarly, re-enabling the rule won't make any difference as it is not the root cause of it. Why? Let's find it out in option A. If you look at option A, it says add data connectors. By default, fusion is enabled. In order to generate the alert, data connector should be configured. That brings us to the answer, that is option A, and hence we'll log this. Alright, this question is about reducing time to deliver messages. This is fairly straightforward question. Dynamic delivery delivers messages as quickly as possible but replaces attachment with placeholders until safe attachments scanning is complete. Also, we need to avoid delay in message delivery while keeping in mind protecting recipients from malware. To achieve this, we need to enable recipients to preview attachments in safe mode when scan is happening. We'll keep option B, dynamic delivery, and reject the rest because they are incorrect, and hence we'll log this. Okay, we are at question number 6 and it's related to conditional access policies and MFA. Let's first look at option B, that is workload identities. A workload identity is an entity that allows an application or service principal access to resources. The problem with workload identity is that it can't perform multi-factor authentication as required here in the question. Therefore, it doesn't look good. We'll reject this. Let's now look at option C, that is filter for devices. Filter for devices is used to target or exclude specific devices in their environment. As per the question, there is no mention of devices like laptop or mobile device, etc. Therefore, seems an incorrect choice. We'll reject this. Let's now look at option D, that is report only mode. Report only mode allows administrators to evaluate the impact of conditional access policies before enabling them in their environment. Doesn't quite look good and fit the question. We'll reject this. And if you look at the official documentation under name location, it's clearly written that name location can be identified by IP4 or IP6 addresses range or by countries. There was a mention of country as far as I remember in the question. Here it goes. So quite fits our question or the requirement. Therefore, we'll lock A, name location, as a correct answer for this. Alright, this question will test your concept on Key Vault. Let's first look at option A, that is permissions for Azure AD. Active directory permission has no relation with key vaults. Seems just a distractor. We'll reject this. Let's now look at option C and D together. That is option C says RBAC associated with key vault, and option D says key vault access policy settings. RBAC for key vault and key vault access policy settings will just check against user permission to key vault and not suspicious IP addresses which we require. Seems incorrect. We'll reject this. We are left out with only one option, that is virtual networks and key vault firewalls, and we'll log this as the correct answer. Alright, another straightforward question related to Azure Defender, and it's related to protecting on-premises computer. Seems interesting. A machine with Azure Arc enabled servers will become Azure resources. When we are done installing log analytics on it, it will appear in a Defender for cloud with recommendations like other Azure resources. So from a source, it's Azure Log Analytics agent. Therefore, option B looks good. Reject the rest and lock Log Analytics agent as a correct answer. Alright, this question is a quick refresher from the previous few questions about transient and permanent failures. We need to figure out permanent failure in this question, which should be the odd one out. Apart from option C, that is permissions to one of the data sources of the rule query were changed, rest other belong to the category of transient failures. Because if we look at option C, without human intervention, will not return to their former status. We will keep option C and reject the rest. And the same, if you look at the official documentation, I have marked the incorrect ones with a red tick here. You can go through it. You got to be familiar about transient failure and permanent failure because it's included in the later syllabus. And in the interest of time, if you look in the yellow highlighter here, that is the right answer for this question. Permissions to one of the data sources or the rule query were changed. We got our answer and hence we'll lock C as the correct answer for this. Okay, we are at question number 10. It's related to machine learning. Seems interesting question. Data scientists use Jupyter Notebook, that is Python code, to work with machine learning tools. Also, notebooks are meant for visualization. Quick tip for the exam, whenever you see keywords like machine learning, just like this, then notebooks, that is option A, looks good and it should strike in your mind. Therefore, we'll reject the rest of the option and lock A as the correct answer. So please don't go away. Let's meet in part 2 of SC-200.